Daddy, don't try to run from the hug. To be. It's so, what time is it? Morning. Okay, bless you. It's service time. Service time.
Fall on me, anointing. Fall on me. Let the power of the Holy Ghost fall on me. Fall on me.
That's a good one. That's a good one.
Anointing. Fall on me.
About the anointing today.
Oh, no.
Come on, tell somebody, we're going to worship no matter who's here. Because I'm up in here. Say amen, somebody. Tell somebody, praise is personal. You don't have to look at your neighbor. Yeah.
Anointing.
Oh, yeah, oh, yeah.
Fall on me.
Some praise in the house. Amen. Amen. Anybody want an anointing to fall on me? Come on, tell God, I said, hey, Lord. Fall on me. Tell your neighbor.
I wish I was this driver when you was in the club, just sitting up there looking at the artists. You know right now, Mary Kay died or somebody was singing. You be waving at the stage, taking pictures with your phone. Y'all my praise to set up in here. How many know that God is able? It is the anointing that destroys the yoke. It is the anointing that breaks your situation. It is the anointing that's your name. What's your problem today?
Jesus went to Calvary to save us. raised him through a climate of craziness. His mother, by being on crack, she was coming to the house, stealing stuff, stealing the toaster, stealing the VCR, and she's stealing this house to support her crack addiction. And as this was going on, the young boy got caught up in all kinds of stuff, been in gangs, been shot. He was a regular in juvie, but mother, he had a praying grandmother. She kept bringing him to church. Sometimes he'd slip out the side door, doing service. Meet his buddies, smoke weed, sip some yak, but grandmama never stopped praising. Grandmama worked two jobs and would come home in between shifts to help him with his homework because she realized that he's just in a bad situation, but he had the potential to be everything. Her lifelong prayer was, God, just let me see my baby graduate from high school. Lord, I want him to be the first. I want him to go to college, make something out of himself. Lord, it ain't his fault that he had to grow up in this environment. And she prayed every day. So all of a sudden, it clicked. And he started going back to school. So one day, grandma is at home and she gets a letter from the high school. Oh, yes.
Thank you.
The letter said, not only is your grandson graduating from high school, but he's graduating top of his class. Grandmother got her outfit out. She wanted to look pretty. She had a white dress, but it was her usher uniform. So she just took the usher tag off. Then she grabbed her big Kojic convention hat, got a long fancy usher gloves. Y'all, she was super Saint Sharp, had on her going to meeting debonair. So she made her way to the graduation, being held in that big old high school stadium. She was late and had to sit at the top of the bleachers. But she gonna see her boy graduate. She coming to graduation praising God.
Thank you, Jesus, thank you, thank you.
She was praising him. The only problem, y'all, is that this was a dignified school. So as they got ready to issue the diplomas, the principal came to the mic and said, ladies and gentlemen, as we confer these diplomas, we would like for all of you to hold your applause and hold your praise until the last name has been called. Now, as fate would have it, this boy's name was Young. And grandmama, when they started with the A's, she praising God. Amos Anderson. They started with the B's. She praising God. They started with the C's. She praising God. They got to the D's. People looking at her like, grandmama, hold that down. This is a dignified commencement. So then, when they got to the P's, he stepped to the mic and he acted like he was talking to everybody, but he really talking to grandma. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to ask you once again, would you please hold your applause and hold your praise? But she just kept at it. So he said, security, would you go and tell her what the consequences could be? But look at grandmama. When she got through the security guard, he started crying. The security guard started leaving it. The security guard started coming in. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please hold your applause until the last name had been called. But grandmama, she just kept on praising. She kept on praising. And by the time she got down, as they were getting close to her grandson's name, grandmama was going in at the podium. Grandmama was praising God at the podium. Grandmama was blessing God. Grandmama was blessing God. Well, I got to stay. We're going to let grandmama have her praise. But I need to leave grandmama's praise right now. And I need to come up in here with a praise report right now. But as I give a praise report up in this place, ladies and gentlemen, I need for you to hold your praise and hold your applause until I give the last praise report. But we got a brother over here where the doctor thought it was cancer, but they came back. Ladies and gentlemen, I need for you to hold your praise until it was over. Just two Thursdays ago, Captain was in the hospital with chest pains, could have been dead, but suddenly she was back at church. Ladies and gentlemen, I need for you to hold your praise. Some of y'all know right now they had given up on you. Ladies and gentlemen, please, I need for you to hold your praise. You need to understand that Corey was in the hospital just Thursday evening with the same chest pains, but he's back at church right now praying for the ladies. Ladies and gentlemen, I need for you to hold your praise. I gotta tell you, some folks said you'll never be nothing. Some folks say you never have a job. Some folks said you'll never be nothing, but you're still here. Ladies and gentlemen, I need you to hold your praise. I got to get out of here, y'all. But tell your neighbor, you don't understand. I've got a disease in me that I can't help it. Tell your neighbor, I can't help. When I think about what God's done for me, I gotta give God praise. I gotta give God praise. Ladies and gentlemen, I'll be good to you. You said you weren't gonna tell nobody, but you just couldn't keep it to yourself. Tell your neighbor, I don't mean to act like this, but God's